to your many admirers giving a birthday party in your honor, which you richly deserve. You have contributed much in the world of entertainment.
That's America to words, but I want to say first, I couldn't tell just before I came, you know the pressure of the play is pretty hard, but I wanted to be able to certainly sing a song or two in thanks. I've got a lot to say that's very close to my heart. I'm going to make it as short as possible a little later, but before I tire my voice even that much speaking.
So deeply that the future of all the peoples of the world is one, and that there must be cooperation from all parts of the earth. And I speak with particular pride as an American and as a Negro, as I said, but stemming beyond that to an inclusion, as you know, of all the peoples of the world. And this began as a boy, as I've said before, in a Jersey town where I played with boys and girls of all the American peoples coming from various lands in Europe, and where I found as a child, together with many difficult times, at other times like tonight, evidences of that kind of democracy that we hope to build forever in our land and in many other lands. The Negro people, who also, they have had a great past, they can have a great future. That you are dealing with a people who are just as able to advance as any others. This point will become of great importance just a little later. But at the same time, with this pride in my own group, I, as I say, as a boy, knew that I had friends everywhere, white boys, Chinese boys, in our American scene, Latin America. It would come in some kind of struggle that would include a struggle for freedom of all peoples. This came much sooner than one could think, but it is here.
I'm curious.
And I had got interested in many languages and in many cultures. I wanted to know people when I went to their countries. I wanted to be able to sing in their languages and to say hello to them. So from the cultural background and from a love of their songs, I came to know the people themselves and came to have a deep interest in their struggle. And I say that today would include certainly all of the peoples from one end of the world to the other. And they too, I'd hope also that by singing this Chinese song or this Czech song, this Russian song, this Norwegian song, to point out to them that these are the forces of freedom. But as I have outlined time and again, freedom really cannot be, the struggle for freedom can never stop, really. It's had a long history, little by little. It's been a tough job. We human beings seem to have been, somehow we don't quite seem to want to give this freedom to the other people. And in many cases in history, as we know, and within very recent time, we have seen that people will so fight for their freedom that if it is not given to them, they will take it. Call firm for a decent kind of world. There are a powerful small group, however, who say, we will dominate this. We will see that there is that nothing flows from Tehran. Nothing flows from this talk of a unified world. We will see that there will be no talk of the freedom of the African people or of the Chinese people. We will create a new kind of imperialism. That's what we face. And as Mr. Toledano says, fascism destroyed in Asia and in Europe says we will find a new foothold on the American continent. What shame that the thought could ever occur that we American people could so act and be so non-understanding that fascism could think they could gain a foothold upon our continent. American can be put in colonial serfdom in Dakar or in Liberia or in the French Cameroons or in any other part of Africa. This is very close and closer than we know because America myself.
That
in the same measure, or perhaps in greater measure, the people...